Hey, babe.
Hi, babe.
It's really nice to be with you, really up close and personal.
Hello. We are going to get
Oh.
started. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the press conference. We are joined by T1, Carpe, and Rossi. We're going to start with some pre-submitted questions first. So this question goes to either of you from the Valorant competitive community. How does it feel finally being at an international event?
일단 저희가 마드리드를 못 가고 되게 아쉬워했는데 이번에 플레이오프 때 되게 잘해서 이렇게 다 같이 상하이에 오게 돼서 되게 기쁘고요. 저희가 인터내셔널에서도 이제 잘할 수 있다는 거를 좀 보여주자는 마음으로 준비하고 있어요.
It was definitely disappointing to miss out on Shanghai, but I'm really happy that our boys pulled together and performed really well in playoffs to get here. And now that we're finally here, I just really want to prove that we can be international contenders.
Thank you very much. Next question goes to Rossi from Gosu Gamers. How do you adapt to T1 playstyle and culture so quickly, considering there might be differences between the US and South Korea?
I'm a pretty intense person, and I've had my own issues being in America for those reasons, honestly. So going here, I feel like the people match my energy very well. And then culturally, I dated a Korean girl, so I already knew what to expect, so it's pretty easy.
Thank you very much. We're going to go to remote media questions. First question from FOMOS.
네, 안녕하세요. 저 카르페 선수한테 질문 두개 드리겠습니다. 먼저 하나는 아무래도 이제 국제전이다 보니까 국내랑 상황이 달라서 컨디션이나 이런 부분이 굉장히 중요할 것 같습니다. 현재 팀 컨디션이라든지 건강적인 부분, 뭐 특별히 문제가 없는지에 대해서 여쭙고 싶고요. 그 다음에 이제 대회, 이번 대회가 아무래도 조금씩 다른 부분이 뭐 다른 부분도 있다고 하니까 그런 대회 준비하는 과정에서 좀 신경 썼던 부분이 있으면 어떤 것이었는지 좀 이야기를 듣고 싶습니다.
일단 첫 번째 질문, 컨디션에 관한 거는 솔직히 저희가, 중국하고 한국하고 시간 차이도 안 나고 가깝기도 해서 저희가, 적응하는데 큰 문제는 없었던 것 같고요. 뭐, LA에 간다거나 유럽에 가는 게 아니라. 그래서 그 부분은 되게 좋았던 것 같고. 그리고, 일단은 저희가 경기 준비하는 거에 대해서는 솔직히, 뭔가, 좀 멀리 있는 뭐 다른 팀들을 준비하는 것보다는 일단 저희 눈앞에 있는 G2 상대로 뭐좀 준비하고 좀 그렇게 하나하나 좀 해결해 나가는 식으로 할것 같아요.
Thank you very much. Next question from B Valorant.
Hello. This question is for the both players. Come to China play. In a Chinese server, maybe a completely new experience. May I ask if you have any feelings about the experience of playing in China server and playing against Chinese player?
Playing in the ranked servers and the Chinese servers has been really fun. They're all
Yeah, playing the
really,
ranked
really,
server.
they're all really, really good. And it's been a fun experience. It's definitely humbling sometimes because of how good they are. So it's just been a fun and great experience. 저도 뭐 중국 서버에서 게임을 해봤는데 사실 에이펙 서버랑 크게 뭐 다르다고 느껴진 것도 없었고 되게 여기 안에 있는 플레이어들이 되게 잘한다고 느꼈었고 네, 재밌게 하고 있습니다.
For me, I didn't feel like there was a big difference between the Chinese server and also the Apex server, and I feel like there were a lot of good Chinese players.
All right,
Thank
thank you.
you. Next question from Adli VLRGG.
Discussion is for Carpe. Since we have seen that Xcurrent is taking the Aiel role back in the Pacific, we've seen how T1 have adapted to his style of calling. How extensively have Xcurrent's calling been throughout the scrim so far? And how is your pulse meshing well with his? Thank you.
저랑 케빈이랑 IGL을 바꾸긴 했지만 사실 저희가 게임하는 큰 스트럭처들은 변하지 않았다고 생각을 하고요. 저가 콜을 하는 거나 케빈이 콜을 하는 거나 되게 비슷한 결로 하고 있다고 생각을 하고 이제 케빈이 IGL을 하게 되면서 제가 조금 더 저의 메카닉에 집중을 할수 있고 케빈은 이제 IGL을 CSGO에서도 오래 했고 경험이 많기 때문에 네, 서로에게 좀 이득이 되는 그런 것 같아요.
Well, even though Kevin did take my role as the IGL, when you look at it in a bigger perspective, our whole system or the way we play the game didn't really change that much. And plus, I guess we kind of call in similar ways, so our play style did not get hugely affected. Also, when it comes to Kevin doing the calls, he has a lot of experience being the in-game leader in CSGO, and that enables me to focus on my aim and focus on my mechanics a lot more. So I guess it's a win-win for both of us.
Thank you. Next question from Elizabeth, The Score Esports.
Hi everyone. My question is for Rossi. So my question for you is that you and your team have defied many expectations qualifying to Shanghai. You went 2-4 in the group stage. Then your best placement thus far in international tournament was actually in the off season, where you're 3rd to 4th in Africa. And you guys have been playing great. You defeated Gen G to help get here. Rather than asking about the pressure, I would love to know about what expectations you have put upon yourself for this tournament. Because to be frank with you, Rossi, you have made an incredible journey across the ocean and done incredibly well. So where do we go from here?
So thank you so much for the kind words. To answer your question, honestly, our own expectations are much different than the public. To be honest, the public thinks we're terrible and that we're not going to win at all. I mean, I don't blame them. We did look abysmal for a while. But our expectations is just to probably get make playoffs. I would say that's the minimum expectations for us. Obviously, we're gonna try our best, and yeah, that's basically it. But once again, thank you so much for the kind words.
Of course, man. All you. Best of luck.
Thank you. Next question from Azri Gosu Gamers.
Hey guys, welcome to Shanghai. Really, just we managed to catch like a glimpse of the team chemistry that you guys had between each other, like just calling like, "Hey babe, how are you babe?" and stuff. So we caught like a little bit of that. So I just wanted to check in on you guys. How do you feel? Is the team confidence pretty high right now? I mean, it looks like you guys have got good chemistry and familiarity with each other. So just want to check on your confidence level for BCD Shanghai.
I mean, we've always had a really good vibe and stuff like that. We've never had any issues with, like, since day one. We've always really had good chemistry in and out the server. So that's never changed. I think our confidence in some of us after the DFM game did waver, and other teams gained a lot of confidence because they're like, oh, how did these guys lose to like a team that's never won? So that definitely did affect us a little bit. So some of us at least. But I think now we're feeling really good. And yeah, I mean, especially because we beat Gen G to qualify here. And then we were like sick after that, so we weren't really in our best condition. But now we feel great, like physically and mentally. So we're all in good spirits.
That's great to hear. All the best to you guys, man.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next question from Arnab.
Hey guys, my question is for Rossi. I think this will be a kind of a revenge storyline for you. Playing against G2 as well as Saya player playing against his old teammates. Do you guys have met them yet? And is there any banter between you guys before the match?
I'm a pretty humble guy, so I would never have any banter or anything like that. I just talked to some of my friends on the other team. So I've just talk about life. I haven't talked to some of these guys in a long time or seen them. So it is a pleasure seeing them. Honestly, I never beat G2 in my career, even in tier one and in tier two. I'm like 0-2 or something. They did have Saya. Actually, yeah, one time they did have Saya. So I'm glad he's on my team now. So hopefully I can get my first win against them.
Thank you and congratulations and best of luck for Shanghai.
Thank you. Next question from Sky.
Hi, this is Sky, and this question is for Carpet. I saw that you swapped the jersey with TZH from DRG. Is there any backstory behind? Was that planned?
그때 저지 수합을 하고 사실 그때 저지 수합을 하면서 얘기해 줬는데 원래 오버워치 중국 2티어에서 선수를 했다는 거를 알려줬고 그래서 뭔가 좀더 반가웠고요. 오버워치를 같이 했던 선수로서 이렇게 발로란트에서 인터내셔널 무대까지 올수 있게 된게 되게 반가웠고 네. 그런 얘기를 좀 나눴습니다.
Well, he told me when we were exchanging jerseys that he actually used to compete in Tier 2 Overwatch as well. So it was nice to see someone from the same Overwatch roots make it all the way to the international event in Valorant. So it was very wholesome and heartwarming experience.
Thank you.
Next question from Pedro Romero.
Hello, I got a question for Carpe. Given all of this conversation going on about, the state of the team, how it's doing, the pressure it has within itself, and also the pressure around you guys, I just want to know, as one of the few that have remained with the roster from last season, what do you think has been the one thing that kind of changed the most from last year to this year?
일단 제가 제일 많이 바뀐 것 같고요. 일단 뭐팀 분위기나 뭐 이런 것도 전체적으로 많이 바뀌었지만 제일 중요한 거는 제가 경험이 많이 쌓이고 하면서 제가 어떤 게임을 하고 싶은지 제 스스로 좀 알게 된것 같고 그게 사실은 제일 크다고 생각을 해요, 저는 개인적으로.
Well, I would say the biggest difference would be me, myself. I mean, of course, we have a new roster. There's new type of chemistry or synergy around the team. But for me specifically, I was able to build up the experience from last year and also have a better understanding of the game. So I would say definitely the biggest change was, within me.
Thank you. And the final question will be from Ravish.
Hi guys. So my question is for Rossi real quick. Rossi, I wanted to ask, man. One thing you said was you said that you got the entire team sick right before the finals. What did you do? Did you sneeze on them? Did you feed them something? What happened, bro?
Honestly, I was just feeling very what's the word? I had a lot of love. I have a lot of love in my heart. I have a big heart, so I always want to hug my teammates and give them a lot of affection before a match. So the whole week leading up to it, I was just really hugging them and showing them so much support out of the game as well in game. So yeah, that's what I did. Unfortunately, I was sick. Honestly, I kind of do it for myself. I don't really do it for them. So I feel bad.
Oh, good man. Hope you stay clear of anything else and stay healthy, bro. Can't wait.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was the final question. So we'll wrap our press conference with T1. Thank you very much.